Hi everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and behind me is the new 2020 Jeannot 490 Sun Odyssey. So this particular vessel has a phenomenal deal on it. It is right here in San Diego, California, turnkey and ready to deliver next week if you're looking to get out on the water. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this amazing vessel has to offer. All right, so here we are starting up at the bow on the starboard side of the Jeannot 490 Sun Odyssey. One thing I want to point out to you is this dramatic hard chine starts up from the bow and it carries all the way down through the stern of the vessel. This has really powerful dynamic lines, gives you phenomenal stability, and really balances the vessel out. As we make our way aft, again, you can see these large ports and just great style and design. The 490 Sun Odyssey is a Philippe Rion hull design, and he is known for very powerful, stable, easy to handle offshore cruisers with also phenomenal performance integrated into it. The vessel itself also has twin rudders, which really balance out to this wide vessel quite nicely. Jeffa steering, top the line steering system, and a really phenomenal feel underway. So if you're looking for a vessel that not only has phenomenal creature comforts, but actually sails, the 490 Sun Odyssey is something you need to take a serious look at. All right, we're here at the transom, and as you can see, a full drop-down transom. This is actuated by a switch in the cockpit and also a remote switch. So if you're coming up from your dinghy, you can actually push a button and this will drop down, so it greets you quite nicely. There's a four-step boarding ladder here, and again, great accessibility into the vessel. We also have a storage area that is designed for a life raft that you can have access from the top as well, and a full integrated area for the generator. All right, so as we step on board the vessel, we have a hot and cold swim step shower off to the port side, lots of storage throughout the vessel, and again, what a phenomenal cockpit. One thing that's really unique about this is the starboard side of the cockpit. This back actually drops down and turns into a lounge. There's a filler piece that goes here. So this is one large lounge area. Really impressive, giving you some really dynamic laying out areas and just really utilizing its space quite effortlessly. So I'm gonna actually work my way up to the bow before kind of going into all of the technical aspects here at the helm. But again, as you just saw, I'm walking up with no stepping right up to the bow of the vessel. You're also gonna notice we have our Genoa tracks here. We have our inboard, outboard shrouds. So I'm walking up to the bow with ease. You can integrate a really nice bow cushion here just to utilize this space. And then as we are coming up forward, we have a full sail locker below us here and a separate isolated anchor locker integrating into our bowsprit with a single roller. We have a tack attachment points there for code zero and asymmetrical. Looking back aft, you can see all of the overhead opening hatches that just really flood the vessel with natural light. They're all flush, and you can imagine the airflow that you'll get. Now, this is the classic mainsail. Now, what's really unique about this is they've actually lowered the gooseneck down. And by doing this, there is so many advantages. Not only the advantage to being able to stand here and get to the top of your stack pack to zip up the zipper, but you're increasing sail area. They're bringing that sail area down lower. So again, everything in its design is to create stability, but look how easy it is. Most traditional stack packs, you're climbing up on ladders. I mean, you're just, it's an obstacle course, but with this new design, being able to carry a classic mainsail on a new modern boat is very innovative, not to mention all the added sail area that you get from this. So again, a really incredible design here, and it really just shows to its detail. Again, accessibility to the bow, maneuverability, and you know, full, you know, 360 degree walk around space is pretty unique here in this particular yacht. All right, so we're coming over to the port helm, and being here at the port helm, again, with just gradual walk around, accessibility. We're sitting down. We have really phenomenal view up forward. We have access to our Raymarine chart plotter that has autopilot integration, wind, depth, speed, anything that you want here. When you're at the helm itself, you also have accessibility to your two-speed Harkin winch with your main sheet and Genoa sheet. So once your mainsail has been deployed, everything you're doing is back here. You're controlling your main sheet, your Genoa sheet, all from behind the helms, and you're not interrupting any of your guests on board. Here in the cockpit table, we have the Raymarine autopilot, but we have cockpit table lights, ambient lights, our platform up and down, our 12-volt outlet, cockpit speakers. We have really clever line lockers for our sheets, cockpit speakers, and at the starboard helm, one thing I want to point out is when you're sitting here at the starboard helm, again, look at our forward visibility, our maneuvering. We have access to our throttle control, our bow thruster control, our windlass chain counter, and our VHF, our chart plotter. And look at that. Directly across from us without having to lean down, bend over, we have our Yanmar display for our RPM gauge. So again, lots of detail and thought has gone into this design, and it is quite, just incredible about what we're actually experiencing here and just the overall fluidness. Now, I can go into the lockers, but this is a quick one. So this is a self-draining locker. So let's say you have wet fenders or dock lines, that could be loaded into here so it drains out, and then we have a dry locker on this side. And again, the innovation just keeps on going on and on, but this would be a, hour video if I hit on every little aspect of it. Large, locker space here in the cockpit table, folding leaves on both sides. We have two-speed Harkin electric winch off to the port side and manual off to starboard, but then again, you can just carry it right over if so desired. We have really easy, accessible companionway doors that open right up. A very gradual four-step into the salon of the vessel. So here we are in the salon of the vessel, and I have to tell you, it is very light, it's bright, it's area. We have a forward-facing nav station that also converts into a little dinette nook if so desired. We have great accessibility to our VHF, our Schreiber panel. And again, if I can go into all of these details, I apologize, but the video would just be going on and on. But the Schreiber panel allows us to look at our electricity. We have air conditioning. We also have generator controls from here, water, our battery voltage. It's just an incredible, panel that gives you so much without having to clutter up a full nav station. We have a multi-repeater, inverter controls, Raymarine VHF, our Fusion stereo system with Bluetooth integration, our quick accessibility. So it's one switch and you can turn on all of your nav electronics. So that's how they're making it very simple and sweet. And again, you can see the attention to detail with all of the wood cabinetry, all hardwood trim found on Genoa's. We have one level of floor throughout. So that is something that, I challenge you when you're looking at other vessels to really see, but one level, there is no sills to step over. Incredible amount of storage and design space throughout the yacht. We have LED lighting on all of the floor cabinetry. Directly across from us is our day head and shower. We have a Japsco Quiet Flush, freshwater electric toilets, huge walk-in shower, little sink, vanity, and again, lots of headroom throughout the yacht. The other thing which I've hit on before about the Genoa product is it's all injected molded decks. Again, so you don't need all of this big substructure underneath. It's keeping that weight down low. We have a queen berth, so all three staterooms have true queen size beds. So again, when you're looking at other vessels, I really dare you to compare that. But again, a large queen size berth here, lots of cabinetry, storage. I mean, look at just the attention to detail on the cabinetry, the shelving that's found out, just this louvered, area throughout, and the fit and the finish is quite unique. This is the VIP stateroom, so you have access into the head and shower compartment here. Moving our way across behind the nav station is our second cabin. Again, it's mirrored on the other side, queen size berth, hanging, shelving throughout, lots of storage. And again, a great use of space, zero sills, all flush, one level. huge. I mean, this is an enormous U-shaped salon seating off to the starboard side. Again, every area about the vessel is just giving you that visual out into the water. So whether you're sitting down, you're standing up, you always are having visual outside. And I think that's really important here, and especially it's brought into its design. But this table will collapse down, turn into a bed, turn this into a big, large lounging area, you know, if so desired. We have a really large cabinet here for storage, double stainless steel sinks, midship galley. So now we're going to be talking about midship galley. It is very unique. And the reason they've done this is your pivoting point of the vessel. This is the most stable point of the vessel. And why not have a galley here if you're preparing a meal, to be here, to have your salon directly across from you? It is a comfortable area. We have Korean style cabinet, lots of storage throughout. We also have a top loading fridge access, small freezer compartment, side loading access to the bottom, 3-burner Eno stove and oven. We have our microwave oven that is a pop-up coming right out of the cabinetry right here, and an additional fridge freezer here that pulls out. So again, great use of space, really nice fabrics. Obviously, if this is not your choice, I can get you anything you want. We have the fabric bulkheads and these really cool lamps that they have brought into here. Bose speaker system. And again, I mean, you look at all of the detail that they've done with the cabinetry work, the 110, the USB outlets, our air conditioning controls. You know, it's hidden but easily accessible and really gives you that clean, contemporary, you know, style. Moving up to the master cabin. This is a master cabin that, you know, I have not seen in any boat before. And I really kind of equate this to like a studio apartment in a sense. But centrally located is our queen berth. Again, lighting, drawer space throughout. Really nice little creativity of just integrating just a little shelf here. This is a full hanging locker closet, shelving and integrated into that as well. We have our air conditioning vents. You know, all the top surfaces are leather, aviation style shade. So when you're laying in bed, you have great visual to the water itself. And again, off to the starboard side, a full hanging locker closet here. I have it packed with pillows, so I thought it was a little too much. And then a great area that pulls out. Look at all this different, you know, storage is just key in a boat. So why not just really pull that out? Drawer space, storage space. This is a really good little center island here that you can accommodate TV if you wanted to, or bookshelving. But what a great use of space. And so I find this to be really clever. We have a sink, storage, obviously this really nice port here. We can look out and see the water, integrated LED lights, 110 outlet. And again, what a cool, you know, design, full length mirror. And then our separate walk-in shower, huge headroom, full walk-in shower, plexiglass door that closes this off. Great use of space. I know some of you are asking like, well, where is the head compartment? So that is on the opposite side of the stateroom. So right when we first walked in, this is the head compartment, giving you another sink and a Japsco Quiet Flush electric toilet here. Again, what a great use of space, a cool design, and it really makes the comfort of livability, staying on this vessel, quite enjoyable. Now we're looking aft, so this will give you a nice perspective, you know, of the salon here looking aft. And again, I've probably gone on way too long, but I hope you find this really valuable, and all of the attention to detail, integrated handholds, and again, it just goes on and on. Well, I want to thank you for watching. I hope you found it to be helpful and informative. There are not a lot of boats on the market right now. This is the crazy times that we're in, but this particular yacht has a great value on it. It's here in San Diego, California. It is ready to deliver within, I would say, a week. I would just need to do some final touches, some detailing, any customizations that you would want to it, whether it be Dodger, Bimini, I can add anything that you possibly want, but it's here. It's outfitted quite nicely, again, with air conditioning, generator, full electronics package, radar, AIS, VHF. I mean, the list goes on and on. And so please feel free to reach out to me at any time, day or night. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. I appreciate all of your comments, following everything that I do. And again, at the end of the day, I'm here for you. I would love to earn your business. Thank you for watching.